Alright, flat rate mechanic here, and I just wanted to do a quick video on how you can confirm your repair after diagnosing a P0171 or P0174, which is system lean bank 1 and system lean bank 2. And basically what you're gonna wanna do is look at your fuel trim values. Fuel trim values are very important, or a very valuable diagnostic tool in really diagnosing any kind of drivability issues, because what it's going to tell you is if the vehicle is in good fuel control. And as you can see here, the short-term fuel trim numbers are adding 10%, long-term adding 20%, and it looks like it's pretty consistent for both banks. Bank 2's adding long-term fuel trim is adding 18%. And so on this one, I was suspecting a vacuum leak, and a good way you can verify that is if you bring the engine RPMs up and those fuel trim numbers go down, and it is a vacuum leak, those numbers are going to tend to get less. So I'm going to go ahead and bring the engine RPMs up, and yeah, as you can see, those fuel trim numbers are getting closer to zero, which is where they should be. But really the point of this video, well, let me try and get us to focus here. What's going on? Alright, there we go. Really the point of this video is to show you guys how to verify if you have fixed the problem after diagnosing it. Say you find a faulty mass airflow sensor, or you find a vacuum hose that was loose or whatnot, and in this case it was a vacuum leak. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys where that is. The point of this video is not so much to show you how to diagnose a lean condition, but more or less how to show you how to verify if you've actually fixed the problem. So let's go under the hood real quick, and I'm gonna show you what I found, and then I'm going to fix the vacuum leak, and I'm gonna come look at these fuel trim numbers again, and I'm gonna show you how I knew that that's what fixed it. Alright, so let's go under the hood here. Alright, so we're under the hood here, and this is actually what I found. This vacuum hose came disconnected from the fuel pressure regulator. It's right here. You can actually hear it sucking, and you can hear the idle change as I plug it. But we're gonna go ahead and plug this back in. Go look at our fuel trim numbers and see what happens. All right, so bring these RPMs up for a second here, just so the computer can kind of rethink itself. All right, and as you can see there, now these numbers, the short term is negative, and the long term is 20. So what's going to happen eventually is these numbers are going to zero out, close to zero. These short term numbers, these negative numbers are going to drive the long term back down. This negative 21 is going to eventually make this negative 19 zero. So basically these two numbers are going to meet in the middle. So if after your repair you come in and you're seeing negative short-term fuel trim numbers like we are here, that means that your repair is that is a confirmed fix, basically, is what that is telling you. So fuel trims can be a very valuable diagnostic tool. So anytime you're diagnosing a fuel trim problem, or diagnosing a P0717 or a P0714, and you've replaced some components like a mass airflow sensor, or you've repaired vacuum leaks, you're always going to want to come back in and look at these fuel trim numbers to make sure that is the only source of those numbers. But let's go ahead and let's just run this for a little bit longer here and see how close to zero we can get these numbers. Because if they're still reading positive after a while, that indicates that we could still have some vacuum leaks or some other reason why this is running lean, whether it be low fuel pressure. You know, it could be a number of different things. Like I said, I'll have other videos that will go into that more in depth on how to actually diagnose a lean condition. But as you can see here, our short-term numbers are still negative, and our long-term numbers are definitely going down, and they'll continue to go down the longer this thing runs, and the more it's driven, and eventually these numbers will be close to zero, as they should be. So just wanted to do a quick video on how to confirm your repair after fixing a lean condition. If this video was helpful at all, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will be coming out with a few more videos on fuel trim, definitely, and more in-depth diagnosis. I know there's a lot of stuff on YouTube on fuel trims. I would like to, in the future here, in the very near future, I will be doing a more in-depth, like I said, diagnostic routine on these fuel trim numbers. So be sure to hit the bell notification to be the first to see those videos, and subscribe to this channel. But thanks for watching. Flat Rate Mechanic. Till next time, guys.